In this video, we are going to learn about manpower planning. Let us first take the definition of manpower planning. Manpower planning refers to the process wherein the entrepreneur plans the human resources in such a way that the enterprise has the human resources who possess the desired skill set available at the right time, available at the right place to perform the assigned job. They do the work most appropriate for what they are paid for. In this example, though we have considered the example of an eatery, the concept is applicable to all kinds of businesses and professions. The quantity and quality of manpower in a business is the controlling factor of its performance and productivity. So, to succeed in the business, the entrepreneur should have a good plan so that the qualified manpower is available in abundance. The more attention the entrepreneur pays to the human resource planning, the more he is likely to get the workforce who work dedicatedly, loyal, and efficient. The manpower planning helps the entrepreneur in the following aspects. Selecting the right personnel. To continue the operations of a business, every business need to have the workforce who have the aptitude for work, the qualification, the skill set, knowledge and experience. So, the entrepreneur should plan to recruit right kind or type of person to get the job done. Various job responsibilities like administrators, engineers, managers, supervisors, technical, skilled, or unskilled personnel. The type of manpower that suits the nature of the business activity. Selecting the right number of personnel. This is related to the quantity or count of manpower needed. The following details can help the entrepreneur to arrive at this number. The amount of work to be completed. That means the huge the amount of work, the more the manpower is needed. The less the amount of work, the less the manpower is needed. The working capacity of an average person. In other words, how much work can be accomplished in a given period of time, or for how many hours an average person can work. Number of leaves that are expected to be taken. Rate of labor turnover. This means there will be people leaving the job and there will be new recruitments that will be going on. And depending upon this, he has to plan the number. The number of employees already recruited and on the job. That means currently how many employees are there in the organization. That also should be taken into consideration. So, based on that, the additional capacity of manpower should be recruited. Future growth prospects of the business, either through expansion or diversification. So that if they have any expansion plans, they should recruit more number of persons so that they have the required manpower when the plans for expansion or diversification are about to be executed. Procuring the manpower. This covers the strategies, methods, policies, rules, and regulations related to selection, recruitment, and training. Overall, we can say that the primary objective of manpower planning is to procure the right person at right job and at right time. That covers manpower planning. Thanks for watching. Edixit.com is started to promote effective and efficient learning process to help the students with their learning requirements.